says, I am the Guru. Krishna himself appears in the form of the spiritual master in order to deliver the conditioned souls back to Godhead. Deva Namati Buddha Sutena. One should never consider Gurudev to be an ordinary mortal being possessed of a body made of the five elements. Who is Gurudev? He is the mercy incarnation of the Supreme Lord. Therefore, Gurudev is also called Asrai Bhagavan. Gurudev is that form of Bhagavan in which the jivas take shelter. Therefore, that person who wants the mercy of Krishna, he has to come to Guru, because Guru himself is the condensed personification of the mercy of Sri Krishna. Therefore, yasya prasadam bhagavat prasado, yasya aprasadam nagati kutopi. Because Gurudev is the direct manifestation of the Supreme Lord, when he is pleased, Krishna is automatically pleased. And when he is displeased, nagati kutopi, the disciple cannot make any advancement whatsoever. Therefore, the disciples should never, even in dreams, consider Gurudev to be an ordinary soul. Even you cannot call Gurudev jiva. Gurudev is a separate tattva. So he is an eternal associate of the Supreme Lord. And as an eternal associate of Gaudiya, he has come to this world to deliver the souls back to Godhead. Therefore, the mercy of Gaudiya, the mercy of Dvibhaya Chama, the mercy of the true brother, Chaitanya Nityananda, Dvibhaya Chamatkara, Dvibhagavate Shanga, Kori Shakshatkara. The mercy of the Supreme Lord, Gauranga and Nityananda. What is their mercy? Their mercy is you can meet the two forms of Bhagavatam. One is the book Bhagavatam, but the real Bhagavatam is the Bhakta Bhagavatam. Therefore, from the mouth of the devotee, Gurudev, we receive the instructions of the Supreme Lord. One more thing, then I'll finish. Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, he used to explain, Gurudev is a transparent via medium. Means what? Just like if there's a window, I can see out through the window. And those outside can look through the window to what I'm doing. How do we know what is the desire of the Supreme Lord? We have come to serve Krishna, but what service Krishna wants from us? How do we know? Therefore, Krishna will instruct us through the mouth of Gurudev. And how will we serve Krishna? I don't know about you, but I've never seen him. How we can serve Bhagavan who is beyond our mind and senses? Therefore, Bhagavan has taken the form of Gurudev in order to accept our service. Therefore, through Gurudev, the mercy of Krishna comes to us, and through our service to Gurudev, our service reaches the Supreme Lord. So we are very lucky we have come here to hear. So Gurudev always says, make sure it doesn't go in out one ear and out the other. At the end of the class, we shouldn't ask, how was the class? Oh, great class. What did he say? I don't know, I forgot. So we come here very carefully. And everything we should hear, Guru Maharaj always says, we should hear to follow, not just hear to hear. Therefore, disciple means who follows the instructions of Gurudev. So we've all come here for the next 7 days. We get a chance to dedicate ourselves to the Supreme Lord through faith and shelter of the bona fide Guru. Go Premanandji.
First of all, I offer my most humble obeisances unto the lotus feet of my Diksha Guru, Param Pujya Pad Param Arajya Sri Srimad A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. And then again, I offer my equal humble obeisances unto the lotus feet of my Shiksha and Sannyas Guru, Param Pujya Pad Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, and unto all of the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis headed by the Sannyasi Dhan, Brahmacharis, Vaishnavis, Rangabhat Pranam. Another point that I would like to make is something that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur talks about in the Bhakti Tattva Vivek, which is a very important point in these present times. That if one does not have Sarup Gyan, if one has a desire to cross over the ocean of birth and death in the material world, but he has not yet received Sarup Gyan, even if he is duly initiated
by a bona fide acarya and a bona fide sampradaya. But he does not yet have his root jnana, then he must receive it from a shiksha guru. This instruction is given by Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Bhakti Tantra Jadeva. In this way, he will get his Vasti Prabhupada. So it is very important to understand that even though we are properly initiated, there are many devotees who are disciples of Srila Prabhupada who have been initiated. But yet, their knowledge of Krishna consciousness is not complete. Therefore, without the Surupyan, they must get the complete knowledge from the association of the present manifest acharya, the Shiksha Guru, Srila Bhaktivinoda Narayana Goswami Maharaj. The Shiksha Guru should be equal in quality to the Diksha Guru. There is one time Srila Prabhupada was giving lecture, and he said, if a person wants to become a doctor, he cannot become a doctor simply by reading a book. He will have to go to the university and learn from the professors and read the book there. And then he will get his degree and become a doctor. So the disciple then asked Srila Prabhupada, so if someone doesn't understand your book, does that mean they have to come to you, the author, to understand your book? Srila Prabhupada said, no, no. Not that you have to come to the author, but anyone who knows the subject matter. In other words, someone equal to him who knows the subject matter, a Shiksha Guru. If you go to him, he can explain. Then the disciple asks, oh, what about your purports? Can we understand by reading your purport? Srila Prabhupada said, no, no. If you do not understand what is in my book, then you have to go to someone who knows the subject matter. He can explain. It's very important to understand. The Srimad Bhagavatam is the sound incarnation of Krishna. But the sound incarnation of Krishna cannot be understood directly by the senses of a conditioned soul. He must hear it from the transcendental sound vibration from the lotus lips of the sadhu, who has not any contamination of the modes of material nature. If you are chanting your japa and you are chanting namapara, the holy name is also the sound incarnation of Krishna. If you are chanting namapara, either orally, loudly, or silently in your mind, then when you chant the verses of Bhagavatam, you will also be doing apara. You cannot chant your name unless, or pure verses of the Bhagavad, unless you hear from the transcendental sound vibration from the lotus lips of the sadhu. The sadhu is in direct contact with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. When he speaks Srimad Bhagavatam, or even if he speaks the most simple, routine, apparently mundane speech, like hello, how are you, you should understand that it is filled with the ras and the bhav of praying in relationship to Radha Krishna Leela. You should understand the juice and the nectar of transcendental ecstasy that is always emanating from the lotus lips of the sadhu. This is not a mundane sound vibration. This is a transcendental sound vibration. And only when we come in contact with hearing the transcendental sound vibration from the lotus lips of the sadhu, can the subtle body gradually dissolve and the spiritual body manifest, and then we can attain our sarup jnana. So those who have not attained sarup jnana, even though duly initiated by a bona fide guru and a bona fide sampradaya, must get it from the Shiksha Guru, who is presently now the Vaishnava Sarvabhauma, the commander-in-chief of all Vaishnavas in the world, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami.